If you hang around the sport of fishing long enough, you'll hear the tall tales, you'll see the videos, you'll read the articles, and some of these things are so weird they're almost impossible to believe. We're here to prove one of those strange happenings about a crazy way that fish can be caught in only one spot on the planet. I'm glad you're with us. The next half hour could prove to be truly spectacular. Let's Fish TV is on the air from Georgia right now.
That is a fish.
Oh man, look at this.
It's time for the only program that brings you real-time fishing reports from the Southwest region every week.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, look at that.
Woo! This is Let's Fish.
Hi everybody and welcome to Coastal Georgia. For many years, I've been hearing about some incredible fishing going on only right here, about some fish that are being caught in such a strange way, it's nearly unbelievable. We're here today to either verify or debunk the way these fish are getting caught. We're going triple tail fishing on this week's show. We'll describe to you what that fish is and what he does and how they're being caught only right here. Now, as you can see, we've got the Blazer Bay 2420 GTS, the beautiful dream machine, already launched and ready to go. And as a matter of fact, if you look just to our right, that is the bridge that connects Brunswick, Georgia to St. Simons Island. Now, St. Simons Island is a vacationer's paradise. There are vacation homes, resorts, beaches, big hotels, golf, and there's a lot of good fishing that goes on around here as well. We're gonna hitch up with a good buddy of mine who guides on these waters every day, and we're gonna show you this incredible thing that's happening only right here to catch triple tail. While we're out doing that, we're taking you around your local region for this week's fishing reports from our expert team of insider reporters from lakes, rivers, and bays, right where you live, both saltwater and freshwater. Right now, we get the Blazer Bay 2420 GTS out into the Atlantic Ocean. Next time you see me, I'll be out there describing the setup for this unbelievable fishing that only happens here. Right now, let's get it started. Back at the studio and your weekend planner.
Hello, glad you're with us. These lunar tables are indicating fair game fish activity for both days this weekend. Peak daytime hours begin at 3:36 on Saturday and 4:37 on Sunday afternoon. The best nighttime fishing will begin after 2:59 on Saturday and 4:01 Sunday night. Depending on your area, the sun will rise around 6:55 and set at 8:03. In evenings, we'll have a moon that is only 10% visible. Stick around, we've got fishing reports from across the area on the way. Plus, I'll return with Bassmaster Elite Angler Todd Otten to answer this week's Ask the Pro question. Stay with us.
Let's Fish TV is proudly backed by Motor Guides Tour Pro, Cable Steer Motor with GPS Anchor, Waypoint Marine, the Gulf Coast's leading saltwater boating specialist, Strike King, Taiwan On, and by Low Boats. Welcome to Low Country.
We have made it out on the Atlantic Ocean. As I described to you, these are the weirdest fish. Got him. Here we go. Get him up on top. It's not a big one, but it's a good start. All right, here we go. Triple tail. Slip the net under him real quick. There we go. All right, everybody, welcome back. We have made it out on the Atlantic Ocean to do some triple tail fishing. And as I described to you, these are the weirdest fish, in my opinion, in salt water. They're not an overly beautiful fish. If you notice, they're just kind of a bronze color. They're big, wide fish this way. A lot of times they're real thick across the back. And here's the deal, I've caught a lot of these in my short saltwater career. Let's let that fish go back. See you, buddy. But here's the deal. Every other triple tail I've ever caught in my life has been near some sort of cover. They get near something either floating in the water or something permanently attached to the bottom. So it could be one of those telephone pole looking navigational markers. It could be a floating nav marker. As a matter of fact, I'll show you some footage that we shot in Mississippi with our drone, but you'll see that this is classic triple tail. They'll literally put their nose on something floating and they'll just lay on the top of the water. And if you get a bait, a live shrimp preferably, around them, they'll bite it. But here's the deal out here. These fish don't do that. This is the only place that anybody's found on planet Earth that triple tail are literally free floating out in the ocean. So we're near Jekyll Island, which is right over here, and St. Simons Island, which is just out of Brunswick, Georgia, on the Atlantic Ocean. And there's just a big, flat beach out here, basically, that runs out to about 10 or 12 feet. And in all the warm weather months, as soon as the water temperature hits about 65 degrees, these fish migrate up here from Florida. They've tracked them, and they just float on the surface, and they feed.
Hey friends, Captain Kevin Broussard here with your Let's Fish Outdoor Report. I tell you what, we're going to start off in Venice, Louisiana. Oh, Josh Howard, lots of tuna, some swordfish, a couple of AJs, snapper good also. Tell you what, Hopedale, Chad Dufresne, and the Dulac Dulage area, lots of redfish, shallow water. Seems like gulp, gold spoons, spinnerbait seems to be the key there. Tell you what, fresh water. Got a report, the water's dropping in the basin, fishing on a turn on there. Also, Toledo Bend. Crappie fishing still good, 25, 30 feet of water, live shiners over brush piles. For old Cajun Phil, Captain Kevin Broussard saying, happy fishing, may God bless you, we'll see you next week.
Pull it up in front of him. He got it, 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 I think. He's biting at the cork. I've got him, I've got him, I got him. That was cool. I saw that fish from a mile away. There we go, not a big one. Come here, let me control you. There we go. Well, there's another one, small one. Triple tail are just, they have some of the strangest habits. There we go. There you go, that's what one looks like. Well, right now we've got the perfect sight fishing conditions. And again, that fish is just laying, look out here, nothing. We're just out in wide open water, nothing anywhere around us. Miles and miles of just Atlantic Ocean, and these fish just come up in sun on top of the water. We've got a big cloud bank coming, and it may get cloudy later on, but right now I can just see them as plain as day. Back that one goes. I do want to tell you that the guy that tipped me onto this and does this, he's done it for 25 years, is Greg Hildreth. He came out just to show me the ropes, to show me what these fish do and where they're located, and the area that they're at. We're marking these fish in just an area, and I don't know why they're sitting in this one area, but I'm going to show you on my Lowrance HDS Live display back there. I'm just crisscrossing with my trolling motor back and forth in one general area, and it's where these fish seem to be, and I'm seeing quite a few fish. Every once in a while, you'll just see one float to the surface. All right, that's what we came all the way to St. Simons Island to do. Catch up. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you want to see more fishing tips, how-to videos, big fish catches, and full episodes of our Let's Fish TV show, be sure to subscribe right here to our YouTube channel. You can also like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. Good fishing out there. Reel this up. Oh, he's a big one. He's a big one. Okay, he's looking at it. He's looking at it. He's right in front of the boat, looking at it. He's got it. Swimming at me. Got him. Look at him. Got him. Swimming right at the boat. Look at him. Big one. Big one. Look at that. That's so cool. Look at this dude. I've got my drag set on my Lose inshore speed stick rod and my Lose inshore speed spool reel. And he is hauling butt. Let's see if I can chase him a little bit. Got him. Wow, that was hard. Look at this dude. Look at this big old dude right here. That's your triple tail for you right there. All right, that's what we came all the way to St. Simon's Island to do, to catch a great old big. Aren't they a strange looking fish? They're just one of the weirdest looking species. Here's the thing about triple tail as well. They're their own species. They're not related to any other fish out here in the ocean. They're just a species all to themselves. They're the triple tail species. And the reason they're called triple tail is, look, he looks like he's got three tails. One, two, three. Triple tail right there. They are a very powerful fish.
Hey, Oklahoma literally has thousands of small lakes and ponds, public and private, some with boating opportunities, some with boating restrictions. Hot weather, you can go early and late, have just a short duration out. That's exactly what Mike Taylor and I did recently to a small pond in the Okmulgee area. And what you would do this time of year is what we did, is fish the smaller baits and don't really care what you're catching. Now, Mike went with the Bobby Garland Baby Shad Swimmer, Blueback Shad Color. I went with the Crappie Shooter in Monkey Milk. Caught some nice bass doing this. We caught some really healthy sunfish. If you don't know where to go right now, here are two good resources to find perhaps some new waters for you. WildlifeDepartment.com, look for their Wildlife Management Areas booklet that has hunting and fishing opportunities. Hey, check these waters out. Check the pond fishing out and you can catch them, but you can't catch them if you don't go.
Hi everyone, Captain Greg Varm here bringing you this week's Upper Texas Coastal Fishing Report. Hey, August is here and water temps are up and fishing is on fire. Let's start right here in Freeport, Texas. I've been offshore every day and targeting kings, amberjack, cobia, and vermilion snapper. Hey, August brings stable weather patterns and light winds. That's what we need to fish in the Gulf of Mexico. Hey, kingfish are coming out of 55 to 65 foot of water, and the amberjack, hey, they're in 180 to 220 foot of water, and live bait works best for those guys. Hey, remember, if you want to fish inshore or offshore, Galveston or Freeport, hey, I'd love to have you aboard. Give me a call, check out our websites. I'm Captain Greg Varm, and I'll see you next week.
Let's Fish TV is proudly backed by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there. Bobby Garland Crappie Baits and the original Baby Shad and new Slab Huntar Minnow. Glacier Glove. Stay outdoors longer with our gloves, hats, and shades. Balls Out. Made in the USA. Heavy duty mounts for your fish finders. And by Camus Boats. Tomorrow's tournament boat today.
Look at that. Look at that, folks. That's a whopper. That's a giant triple tail. Okay, there's one right here in front of the boat. If the boat just won't spook him. The boat just won't spook him. He's swimming all around it. He's swimming all around it. He got it, he got it. Got him, got him. That was weird. That was tricky right there. He is a gone motor scooter too.
monster. This is a monster one here. Oh, what a fight. Oh, man. We got him. We got this bad boy. Look at that. Look at that, folks. That's a whopper. That's a giant triple tail. And I barely had him right in the lip. Right? That was all it took to get him loose. Look at that dude. Oh, wow. I'm looking at 7 minutes on my camera is how long it took me to land that fish. That is a giant triple tail. This is in the 20 pound class, something in that range, maybe 18, 20 pounds. They have to be, I think, 15 or 16 inches long to be a keeper here. This is way big one, but these giant ones like this, we just need to turn these back. So here we go. And away he goes.
Hi everybody, and welcome to this week's Lone Star Lakes, brought to you once again by Dragonfire Tools, makers of the best quality workbenches you've ever seen and veteran owned. Check them out on the web. Now this week we're going to start at Lake of the Pines, where the summer pattern has set up for the bass. You'll find them on offshore humps in deep water. Now the thermocline may or may not have set up. If it has, that helps you by eliminating a lot of those humps. You can find the ones that are above the thermocline and fish those. If, however, there is no thermocline, you'll have to simply go out and use your graph and check them all to find your bass. That's this week's Lone Star Lakes, brought to you by Dragonfire Tools. Be sure and check us out on Facebook, Lone Star Lakes.
Well, just as an added little bonus, I have hooked into a big old redfish out here triple tail fishing and came across the giant school of redfish just swimming across the flat. Up on top. Starting to get a little tired. There, he swam in my net. Unbelievable. Look at this. Holy cow. Well, I was out here catching these triple tail and just looked up, and there was about 150 of these swimming along with their fins out of the water. How about this? Look at that, folks. There's the bonus of St. Simon's Island. You come out here with Captain Greg Hildreth, and you could catch a giant shark, you could catch a big old speckled trout, you could catch a 20 pound triple tail, like some of the ones we've been catching, or you could catch a giant bull redfish. What an incredible deal. St. Simon's Island is one incredible fishery, I'm here to tell you.
Watch our latest episode or catch up on past episodes on our website at letsfishtv.com. Be sure to hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter for new fishing videos every day. And download the free Waypoint TV app to get all the latest episodes every week on your phone, tablet, computer, or smart TV. Let's Fish TV is proudly backed by Mercury, Go Boldly, Lowrance, America's number one fish finder, Lose, Feel the Difference, and by Gulf Shores and Orange Beach, Alabama. Get our free fishing guide at orangebeach.com.
Welcome back, everyone. Let's get right to your Ask the Pro question for this week. Luke wants to know, what age did you start fishing tournaments, and were you any good at it back then? For an answer, we asked Bassmaster Elite Angler Todd Otten.
Well, I know I fished my first tournament when I was 15, and I had to have my parents sign the entry form just so I could go fish. And by that time, you know, I'd fish with my cousins and my dad and everybody to get a little good at it, you know, but I wasn't that good at it. but I caught fish with my pro. I had a ball. I caught more fish than my pro. So I thought that was a feat. That was the only goal I had. You know, it wasn't to win a tournament.
Thank you, Todd, for sharing with us. If you want some help from one of the pros, simply go to letsfishtv.com and follow that Ask the Pro link to submit a question. Now it's time to find out who wins this week's Big Catch of the Week.
Hey everybody, we've made it back to the dock here at St. Simons Island, Georgia, after a fantastic day catching those triple tail and one big bull redfish to boot. I can't say enough about the Blazer Bay 2420 GTS, the boat that was rigged out by Jared Poole and his team at Waypoint Marine in Corpus Christi, Texas. They do such a fantastic job for us. All the details, that cover, that sport top, all of the upholstery, all of the bait wells, live wells, storage, everything you could possibly want in a dream machine. And we enjoyed pulling it all the way down the Gulf Coast and all the way down the Atlantic Coast. And you're looking at their contact information if you'd like to contact them about a dream machine like this one of your very own. It's time right now for this week's winner in the Big Catch of the Week contest. He's Eric Stubblefield of Henrietta, Texas, showing a 7-pound, 4-ounce largemouth bass he caught at McGee Creek Lake in Oklahoma. If you'd like to have a chance to be our next winner and have your fish shown on television, just go to our Facebook page at facebook.com/letsfishtv. Go to our Big Catch post from this past Tuesday. Follow the instructions to post your picture and give us all the details.
Here's today's Right Stuff, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors.
There were two pieces of gear that were absolutely critical to catching those triple tail and the big bull redfish. It begins with the Lewes Inshore Speed Stick Rod Series, perfectly paired with the Lewes Inshore Speed Spin Spinning Reel. It does a great job of fighting all those inshore and offshore saltwater species. It comes in several lengths, several actions. There's one to fit your style of fishing. And the sunglasses that I was wearing, these are the Strike King S11 series of sunglasses. But more importantly, those yellow lenses, they're called Cloud. They helped me to see those fish even in those cloudy, overcast conditions. And then when the sun would pop out, you could see them even better. They're a yellow colored lens that are made for low light conditions, and you cannot believe what you can see. The Strike King S11 series, and check out the cloud colored lenses. So quietly, you may have missed it. Earlier this year, we lost a true American music pioneer by the name of Richard Wayne Pennyman. He passed away this year. You may know him better as Little Richard. He wrote and sang such American classics in the rock and roll business as Tutti Frutti, Long Tall Sally, Lucille, and many more. He's respected as one of the first black crossover musicians that attracted fans of all races. He drew blacks and whites together at a time in the 50s when the rest of the world was trying to pull them apart. Just a little shout out to the memory of a true superhero in the music business whose music will live forever. Little Richard's music passes the test of time, and folks will be listening to his music as long as this world stands. I hope you enjoyed our trip to St. Simons Island, Georgia as much as we did. We had a blast catching all these different species of fish here. And if you'd like to come here, you can contact Captain Greg Hildreth at his charter service, the contact information you see on your screen. He can put you on speckled trout, redfish, some of the sharks offshore, but his real specialty are the tarpon that come here in the summertime and these triple tail that lay on their backs and you can sight fish them. This is the only place on the planet that you can do that. From St. Simons Island, Georgia, until next week, I'm Barry Stokes saying let's fish, everybody. Be safe, have fun. Bye-bye, y'all. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you want to see more fishing tips, how-to videos, big fish catches, and full episodes of our Let's Fish TV show, be sure to subscribe right here to our YouTube channel. You can also like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. Good fishing out there.